What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another Sony camera app tutorial. So the main problem that vloggers and YouTubers have with a lot of Sony cameras is the lack of a fully articulating screen. Cameras like the Canon 80D and Panasonic GH4 are great for allowing you to flip the screen up and to the side so that you can easily see yourself while recording. Some Sony cameras, like the newer RX100 cameras, can flip the screen all the way around, but the majority of their alpha cameras do not. Enter the Smart Remote Control app, a free way for you to turn your cell phone into both a monitor and a controller for your Sony camera. Now, just an aside, I'm using my A6300 with firmware version 2.0 and my Samsung Galaxy S8. I have no idea how well this operates on an iPhone. I would guess it's very similar. This app is free, and although its features are limited, I think it's one of the more useful ones that Sony has put out. Some of the captured phone footage is in a horizontal or landscape orientation, but the app and all menus also function vertically. To connect your phone to your camera, you must first download the Smart Remote Control app. And if you need help installing the app on your camera, I have a bunch of videos explaining how to do this, so check the annotation. Now, download Remote App Play Memories Mobile on your Android or iOS device. It was the first result when I searched the word Sony. Make sure your Wi-Fi on your phone is on and confirm that neither device is in airplane mode. You should only need to set up a connection once. As long as your phone remembers Wi-Fi spots, it should automatically connect once your Wi-Fi is on and the app on your camera is open. Now keep in mind that you do not need an internet connection when pairing devices. The Wi-Fi is just the camera acting as a sort of hotspot for your phone. Use your phone's camera to scan the camera's QR code displayed on the monitor. Your list of paired cameras will appear here in the future. Okay, let's move on to operation. First, set the shooting mode on your camera's mode wheel because you can't change that through the app. You also can't set the frame rate or resolution in app, so do that before you start it up. Go ahead and connect to your camera. In a manual shooting mode, you can control the shutter speed, aperture, and ISO from the live view section of the app. Alright, let's dive into the menu. The menu on your phone will include camera information. Next, you can see in-camera images and videos. So you have to use the menu to set your white balance if you aren't controlling with your phone vertically. You can set a self timer. You can set continuous or single shooting. You can set up your focus mode. And then you can turn on touch shutter. With touch shutter off, you would tap the area you want to focus on and then press the circle button to the side to take the picture, or if you're in video mode, to start recording. If you want to turn touch shutter on, your camera will take a picture immediately after you touch the area that you want to focus on. Then it locks onto this area so that each photo after is locked to this point until you press the green flashing cancel lock. The next part of your menu is the zoom setting. Here you can select optical zoom, which is just your power zoom if your camera supports it, like the 16-50 kit lens or the 18-105 f4 lens. Optical means the picture is only zooming in with the use of optics, unlike the next two options, clear image zoom and digital zoom. Clear image does a pretty good job doubling focal length as long as you aren't at a super high ISO. And the digital zoom option gives you 4 times the focal length, which is cropping, so again, keep that ISO low. Silent shooting is also an option for any camera that supports it. Next, you can change the file size of the reviewed image. The 2 meg option allows for faster review than viewing it at the original resolution. Then you can check your camera's model and firmware version. You can turn image review on or off, as well as set its length. You can choose to save the photos you take to your smartphone device. You can even turn on location information, but I don't really want to get into this because I've never seen a point in geotagging photos. Next, you can turn on a few different kinds of grids. Then you can turn on mirror mode. If you have your phone on top of your camera pointed at you, turning on mirror mode allows you to view a reflection of yourself. Perfect for any vloggers out there. One last cool feature is the little icon you might have noticed in the top right corner of the live monitor on your phone. This allows you to rotate the camera orientation. This is useful if your camera was recording upside down, so that you can still view it properly without having to turn your entire phone. So that's going to wrap up this tutorial. Thank you so much for all your patience and support. I have more videos on the way, but I'm always open to suggestions. And as always, if you like this video, you know what to do.